morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
On a long ride when it's autumn on the trail, I was making one more circle up to the summer range on Becca, looking for cow tracks, still a few pairs up there somewhere. In fact, I think I posted a little video of that ride on my Facebook page. But, you know, it's interesting how your mind wanders as you inhale the fragrance of the falling leaves and feel a warm October sun on your back. And your horse, seasoned and solid from a summer of hard work, just ambles along. And on that ride, my mind went back to Tumbler Ridge, B.C., and a story I recorded from Lenny Primo, and I'll pull it out of the vault today.
And they're just going, how far they had to go, I don't know, but you had to be there to see this. It was the funniest thing you ever seen in your life.
And of course, you'll hear what it was when we open up the vault just a little later. Kathie Moss, known as A.K. Moss these days, still lives and rides in the country of Eastern Oregon. She's a wonderful poet, storyteller, and from what I've been told, a darn good hand with horses. We've had some great candid conversations over the years, and today I'll let you eavesdrop on one of them.
One day you could lead him out of the barn and he'd be fine, and the next day he'd run right over the top of you. One day you could saddle him good, and the next day he'd just take you. And
a lot of breaking stories on the Rangeland News. One of them, where the heck are retail grocery prices hit?
An increase in grocery store food prices next year, a tiny increase, less than 1%.
On the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, something that happens pretty often. At some point on the trail, your horse just stops and resists going forward. Now, I'll tell you what works for me when he does that. And as for the music, we've got lots of it, and it's pure cowboy and what we proudly call Western. Ned Ledoux, son of the great Chris Ledoux, is carrying on the legacy, and as you'll notice, he sounds a lot like his dad.
Remember how it felt, throwing caution to the wind, hanging on a ragged edge, now it's coming back again. To feel a cold sweat trickle down, hot blood in your veins, a little past your prime, the rush is still the same. Carry it on with pride, a passion that burns inside, a love that you just can't hide. When the only thing you live for is to make that perfect right, you're not proving nothing to nobody, just a man down deep inside. You carry on, you carry on, you carry on your cowboy life. Lonely is the highway, morning sun and bloodshot eyes. Through all the aches and pain, the hunger's still alive. A blink of total silence as they open up the gate. In perfect time and balance, giving all that you can take. You carry it on with pride, a passion that burns inside, a love that you just can't hide. When the only thing you live for is to make that perfect right, you're not proving nothing to nobody. Just a man down deep inside. You carry on. You carry on. You carry on your cowboy life. No, it ain't for the money, though money has its place. Yes, it's just a feeling of being in the race, out beyond the limit, where you've never been before. And when it all comes together, that's what you're riding for. a love that you just can't hide. When the only thing you live for is to make that perfect right, you're not proving nothing to nobody, just a man down deep inside. You carry on, you carry on, you carry on your cowboy life. Your cowboy life.
When I did this interview with Kathie Moss, she'd been riding with the legendary ranch couple Billy and Leon Flick in eastern Oregon, and since that time we lost Leon, but Billy is still carrying on.
Kathie Moss is a good hand, a ranch wife from Oregon, and Kathie, I guess you live not too far from our good friends Billy and Leon Flick.
Yeah, the stories that they have, I went down there and helped them calve last year and the year before, and we went out, there was... About 18 miles from where they live is Adel. They live in Plush, and Adel's about 18 miles from there. And they had some cows down there calving. And the dedication that these guys have for the love of what they do and not the money. Billy knew that a cow had had a calf, and she didn't think that that little guy had sucked yet. And so she wanted to go down and check him. So we went down there, and we poured colostrum down, and we found him the first time. And then at the end of the day, we went back and we went to look for him to see if he had actually gotten himself pulled together yet, and we couldn't find him. And we were down there for 3.5-4 hours, and the cows had gotten out on the highway, and somebody had put them back in, and the pasture where they were at was a hay field, and then on the edges was sagebrush and trees, and there was a couple of tractor parts in there. So we were out there looking through all underneath all this sagebrush looking for this baby. We went down on the highway, and we were walking up and down the highway looking to see if we could find this little guy, because we couldn't find him anywhere. And I was thinking, you know, that, well, just tough luck.
Well, tough luck happens when you're raising calves, but stick around, because you'll hear how this story turned out when the Spirit of the West continues right after this.
As the days continue to get colder and shorter and dimmer and darker, the thoughts of cruising around the Caribbean with the Spirit of the West Cruise Gang for 14 days sounds so good. Here's the latest. We're coming close to the end of the current pricing. After November 10th, spots will be based on availability and will be at the rate at the time, not the group rate we have now. The Majestic Princess will visit 8 of the most beautiful ports in the Caribbean, and airfare is included. We set sail from Fort Lauderdale on February 4th with a great group of Spirit of the West fans and followers, hosted by our support crew, Mark and Kathy McMillan. Blue skies, turquoise waters, live entertainment, wonderful food, and best of all, a chance to touch base with all kinds of folks who have the same values and lifestyles as you. Get all the details at our cruise page at hugh-mcclennan.com and call 1-800-530-0131. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. I know that you hear a lot of calving stories here about all the heroics and the tragedies that go on in the springtime, but today I'm looking back at a visit with a fine poet and writer, Kathie Moss, with a calving story.
You see, these two gals, Kathie and her good friend Billy Flick, were searching for a calf that had been born that morning, had not nursed, and they couldn't find the unfortunate little critter, and it was nearly dark by now.
And I was thinking, you know, that, well, just tough luck. And just before dark, Billy says, let's give one more sweep through the pasture before we go home. And lo and behold, in the headlights, we found that little guy. And we loaded him up in the front of the pickup, and we hauled him 18 miles. We drenched him again. We rubbed him down. And he hadn't eaten the whole time. But that dedication for the love of a calf, for the love of a life, is what I write about. And it is an honor to have people like that, that just won't give up, just want that one more try, you know, let's give her one more shot. But they went ahead and drafted that calf a couple of weeks later on a cow. And it was kind of funny because the heifer that they drafted him on was just a wild, snotty little gal, and she had lost her baby. And so Billy thought, you know, this is going to be a hassle. If you ever drafted a calf on a cow, you know that they don't always take to a new calf. And so they were thinking, you know, how are we going to even get this calf close to this cow? And they opened up that back of that trailer, and that calf came waddling out, and that cow took one look at that calf, and she started bellowing, and Billy started pushing the calf towards the cow, and the calf was trying to get towards Billy, and the cow was coming at Billy. So she jumped the fence, and I'll be danged if she didn't mother up to that calf just like that. And she says, you know, that was the slickest thing she ever saw.
All that time, and now you know that there'll be a pair come weaning time.
Yeah, there's a pair there, and everything's hunky-dory.
Well, Kathie looks at her early days and the amazing hardships that her family went through, and that's coming up next. But right now, here's a couple of pretty good hands, and they might be called hands across the border. T.J. Casey from Montana, Jim Reeder from Saskatchewan, and I don't think it's the border that they're trying to get those cattle across.
And I can hear the cattle boss. It's a thundering and lightning, so get aboard your horse. The river's swollen and higher, boys, we gotta get them cattle across. I hear the train coming, boys, we gotta get them cattle across. And I hear that whistle blowing, boys, and I hear the cattle boss. He's roaring like a lion, so put the spurs to your horse. The river's swollen higher, boys, we gotta get them cattle across. The leaders took to water, looks like they're going across. Keep your eyes on them quitters, boys, and listen to the cattle boss. Some's floating down the river, some surely will be lost. Keep your eyes on them quitters, boys, and get them cattle across. Yodelay. Drier, boys, cause most of them have crossed. But something just ain't right here, boys. Where the heck's the cattle boss? He must have went down the river chasing strays on his hoss. Let's separate and find him, boys, cause we got them cattle cross. We found him in a tangled mess. The boss's life was lost. Standing on the river bank was his lonely riderless horse. We buried him at daybreak. Joe made a special cross. He died trying to save him, trying to get them cattle cross.
Kathie Moss is my guest this week, and Kathie, you were saying that a lot of the inspiration for the poetry you write has been inspired by your dad. Can you tell us a little bit about him?
Roy Saul was a ranch hand all of his life, and he was is a very amazing man. We were moving to Baker City, and we got in a car accident, and we didn't have enough money to ride in the ambulance, and so Mom called him as a friend. He's not my first dad, he's my second dad. But anyways, and he housed us kids at his house, and when they got married 3 months later, he took a chainsaw and cut a hole in the floor, and he took in 4 kids as his own, along with his own son. But he took a chainsaw and cut a hole in the floor, and we dug out underneath the house with 5-gallon buckets. And he put bunk beds down below, and we stayed in one room, and they had the other room. It was a 2-bedroom house that we moved into, and he treated us as his own from day one and until today. And he taught me a lot of philosophy about cowboy life, and the stories that he has to say are just absolutely amazing, and I just didn't want to lose them.
Coming right up is a story from the vault that'll have you shaking your head and raising your eyebrows for sure, but it happened exactly that way. You'll hear it when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West.
Stories from the vault, from the Spirit of the West. This is where we dig deep for some of the most amazing stories from the folks who bring some heartwarming, knee-slapping, spellbinding episodes.
It comes from the Grizzly Valley Saddle Club, where I got to visit with longtime horseman Rene Primo.
We were going to a horse sale up in Fairview in northern Alberta with a friend of mine, Doug Ellipin. He wanted to buy a horse. So after the horse sale was over, we seen this guy that bought a Shetland pony. And Doug, a friend of mine, he'd bought a big thoroughbred, so we all take these horses out to load them. We're having a tough time with this thoroughbred, and we can hear these guys swearing like you wouldn't believe about 2 or 3 trailers down. Excuse me. And then we look, and there's about 6 guys. They left this little Shetland on this flat deck. It's a steel flat deck. And then we hear some more cursing, more hammering. And us guys were doing our own swearing, trying to load this thoroughbred. Then all of a sudden, I hear some welding going on. Now what the hell's going on? We look, they had put shoes on this little Shetland pony, and they spread eagle these front feet and back feet, and they tack welded all 4 shoes to this flat deck. And when they took off, this little horse, he leaned back, you know, only as far as he could go. And then they turn a corner, a little Shetland pony leans to the right, you know, and they're just going. How far they had to go, I don't know, but you had to be there to see this. It was the funniest thing you ever seen in your life.
They just welded him right on there.
Oh, yeah, welded all, tack welded all little 4 shoes to the flat deck.
And did you guys finally get that thoroughbred loaded?
After about 15 more swear words, yeah, and about 4 other guys pushing, we finally got them loaded. Eh?
As the days continue to get colder and shorter and dimmer and darker, the thoughts of cruising around the Caribbean with the Spirit of the West crew gang for 14 days sounds so good. Here's the latest. We're coming close to the end of the current pricing. After November 10th, spots will be based on availability and will be at the rate at the time, not the group rate we have now. The Majestic Princess will visit 8 of the most beautiful ports in the Caribbean, and airfare is included. We set sail from Fort Lauderdale on February 4th with a great group of Spirit of the West fans and followers, hosted by our support crew, Mark and Kathie McMillan. Blue skies, turquoise waters, live entertainment, wonderful food, and best of all, a chance to touch base with all kinds of folks who have the same values and lifestyles as you. Get all the details at our cruise page at hugh-mcclellan.com and call 1-800-530-0131. The Rangeland News is next, and you know, if it hasn't happened yet, it's not far away, and this is the son of the beloved Canadian cowboy troubadour, Stu Davis, known as Dwayne Stewart.
The elk are coming down from the hills each morning. The winter grazing's better here below. The evening sky last night was like a warning. It's cold outside and looking like early snow this morning. It's cold outside and looking like early snow. Every year this town is getting smaller. The kids can hardly wait to up and go. And now they've closed the high school down forever. It's cold outside and looking like early snow. This morning, it's cold outside and looking like early snow. Clouds up over the mountains, getting darker every day. As soon as the wind turns westerly, they're bound to head this way. There's been no rain all summer, and all the grass is brown. The rodeo is over, and the circus is leaving town. Another farming family left the valley. They left last night, nobody heard them go. They left the tractor standing in the hayfield. It's cold outside, looking like early snow. This morning, it's cold outside, looking like early snow. The elk are coming down from the hills each morning. The winter grazing's better here below. The evening sky last night was like a warning. It's cold outside and looking like early snow. This morning, it's cold outside and looking like early snow. It's cold outside and looking like early snow. This morning, it's cold outside and looking like early snow.
The Rangeland News from the Spirit of the West. A roundup of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
At the top of page one, it says, for once, wouldn't it be nice to hear a forecast that says retail grocery prices are headed down? Well, not quite. Here's Gary Crawford.
Overall, food price inflation at the grocery store is practically nil this year, with prices expected to average only about 1% higher than last year. And for 2025...
we're expecting to see largely similar trends to 2024, where food prices are expected to increase more slowly than what we've seen in the recent history.
Of course, we know 2025 hasn't even started yet, but for what it's worth, USDA economist Megan Schweitzer is forecasting an increase in grocery store food prices next year, a tiny increase, less than 1%, 0.8%, in fact. And the folks at USDA say that 0.8% is the midpoint, though, of a prediction range that could take 2025 food prices down almost 6% below 2024 levels, or up above this year by 8%. Gary Crawford reporting for the U.S. Department of Agriculture.
A coalition of 46 farming, ranching, and food groups led by RCAF USA is pressing Congress to block an impending USDA rule mandating electronic ear tags for adult cattle and bison crossing state lines. Now, this rule, effective from November 2024, modifies the existing animal disease traceability protocol, which many believe is sufficiently effective. The mandated electronic identification has been criticized for potentially burdening smaller producers and consolidating the food supply chain under major meatpacking firms, thus threatening national food security. And opponents contend that the rule is less about animal health and more about profit margins for multinational corporations and technology firms involved in the production of tagging systems. The initiative has sparked significant backlash, with claims that it would cover only 11% of cattle in the event of a disease outbreak, casting doubts on its overall utility. The groups rallying behind the legislation, such as HJ, Res 167, and several others, are already mounting their opposition in the House. And Bill Bullard, the CEO of RCAF USA, highlights the extensive opposition from producers and stresses the importance of congressional action to prevent the potentially detrimental impact of the rule on the livelihoods of American ranchers and farmers. Well, I don't know. Electronic ear tags work very, very well in Canada. The United States beef industry is experiencing a notable decline in production throughout 2024.
U.S. cow slaughter has decreased by 15% compared to last year, with over 650,000 fewer cows processed. And this drop has contributed to a 12% reduction in lean beef production, which now stands at 1.2 million tons, the smallest volume since 2016. And despite the overall decline, heavier carcass weights and increased heifer feedlot entries have softened the production fall, and total slaughter is down by 4%, but production has only dropped by 1% in 2024, with a similar 1% reduction expected in 2025. The increased heifers' feedlot entry suggests that rebuilding the breeding herd will take longer, slowing future production recovery. Meanwhile, Australian exports to the U.S. have jumped 69% so far in 2024, reaching nearly 235,000 tons, and the U.S. has become the largest market for Australian beef, with Australia poised to meet the growing demand as U.S. supplies tighten. The direct beef sales model continues to evolve, with some producers selling cuts via vending machine, managing aspects such as their own dry aging process, and others are selling beef into niche markets, based on genetic certifiable attributes such as natural, organic, or grass-fed, or other traits such as traceable beef in a farm-to-plate program. There's a lot of steps for producers to consider prior to establishing a direct beef sales venture that goes beyond an initial investment in infrastructure and equipment. In Canada, this includes understanding federal and provincial regulations to provide a safe, high-quality product and requirements for labeling and marketing differential brands to build consumer trust. And in terms of resources, Alberta Agriculture published a document about direct marketing of meat in 2005. The resource recommended a focus on frozen beef, as it was deemed easiest to ensure the integrity of the product and food safety when transporting the meat from remote locations. And while direct sales can help producers diversify their farm income, the resource noted that selling freezer beef will always be more time-consuming than delivering the cattle to a packer, and emphasized the need to plan in advance to make it profitable. It's probably the same in a lot of other areas, but I know there are a lot of smaller ranches and some bigger ones right around here that do market a certain percentage of their cattle by direct selling the meat to consumers. And boy, it's really good stuff. Well, October the 22nd, there's a calf and regular cattle sale at the Kamloops Yards of the BC Livestock Co-op. Then October 23rd, the Williams Lake Calf Sale, and October 24th, the Williams Lake Regular Sale, and October 25th, Vanderhoof Regular Sale with the Angus Influence, and you can get all the information. And, of course, watch the sales live at bclivestock.bc.ca. Meanwhile, at the Innisfail Auction Market, pre-sort calf sales October 21st, 28th, and November 4th. Calves are received Sundays and sorted into groups to be sold Monday. And, of course, regular cattle sales every Wednesday. Just call Mark, Danny, or Dwayne at 1-800-710-3166 or see InnisfailAuctionMarket.com. And now the final item. And we're really enjoying having our grandkids up this summer, our grown-up grandkids, our grandson Mitch, now up in his late 20s, still working on his degree in cognitive sciences, but when he was a little fella, he was a great help up here at the ranch, and he loved to ride, and oh, he must have been, I don't know, 10 or 11 or something. And
we were gathering our little group of cows and calves and trailing them a couple of miles to some spring pasture the day after, on Sunday. And this was Mitch's first cattle drive. Now, we had to take the herd about a half a mile down a winding stretch of gravel road before we were able to go cross country. And I said, Mitch, when we get to the road, you and I will ride at the back. We'll send Grandma up to the front to ride ahead of the cows just in case there's any traffic coming. And he looked at me and he says, oh, I get it. You'd rather have a car run into Grandma than hit one of your cows, right? And that's the rangeland news.
So you're riding up the trail. Lots of trees on each side. The trail takes a bend and your horse stops. And for whatever reason, he refuses to go ahead. I'll analyze that and tell you what works for me on the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, coming right up when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. A look at a horse that just stops on the trail and for whatever reason refuses to go ahead. Coming up on the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File. But first, as the days continue to get colder and shorter and dimmer and darker, the thoughts of cruising around the Caribbean with the Spirit of the West Cruise Gang for 14 days sounds so good. Here's the latest. We're coming close to the end of the current pricing. After November 10th, spots will be based on availability and will be at the rate at the time, not the group rate we have now. The Majestic Princess will visit 8 of the most beautiful ports in the Caribbean, and airfare is included. We set sail from Fort Lauderdale on February 4th with a great group of Spirit of the West fans and followers, hosted by our support crew, Mark and Kathie McMillan. Blue skies, turquoise waters, live entertainment, wonderful food, and best of all, a chance to touch base with all kinds of folks who have the same values and lifestyles as you. Get all the details at our cruise page at hugh-mcclennan.com and call 1-800-530-0131.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
Whether you're in the pasture or the oil patch, you work hard, and you need quality workwear that's up to the challenge. Look no further than Irvine Tack and Western Wear. They've got it all to keep you warm and safe, including fire-resistant and high-visibility clothing, featuring the biggest names in workwear from Ariat, Burn, and Wrangler. Stop in or shop online at irvins.ca, exit 305, off Highway 2 by Crossfield.
The world's greatest Western store.
When you meet with resistance, try backing away. From the early groundwork to the first few rides, I like to have a horse back up softly, willingly, and straight into my hands. Where this can really help is when you're on the trail. And let's say your horse stops because something up there is concerning him, or he doesn't want to walk across a soft, wet spot or a little creek. There are dozens of things in the bush on the trail that can cause concern and resistance to going forward in a young horse or maybe an older one. If you can just start backing him away from that spot for 5 or 10 steps or so, then stop and ask him to go forward, it takes his mind off what's causing the resistance, and it also sets up a go-forward response after the backup. You can usually advance past the first point of resistance by a few steps when he stops, instead of urging him forward by backing him up again. And then you just build your progress in small increments. It kind of relates to the yo-yo game in natural horsemanship, and it's amazing how well it works.
And for Irvin Saddles and Western Wear, that's this week's Horse Training File. Something else that works really well with our horses is a daily feeding of Hoffman's Horse Ration. Find out why it works so well and what's in it at hoffmanshorseproducts.com. If you're buying or selling farm machinery, heavy equipment, or trucks, let Progressive Auctions take the hassle out of your sale or your search. There's an online auction every Wednesday at progressiveauctions.ca. Doesn't matter where you live, Progressive Auctions can find the machinery or equipment you need or the buyers who are looking for what you're selling. Progressiveauctions.ca. For more information, call 844-309-9424. Kathie Moss talks about some of the horses that she started over the years, including a real tough one or two, and they might have been something like the subject of this song, written by Randy Houston and sung here by R.J. Vandegrift.
You ease up in the saddle, it's frosty and first light. Your pony's walking on eggshells as a chill runs down your spine. Just when you think you've stolen a ride and the hair lays down on your neck, both barrels blow.
thin air, and it hits with a mighty force. Keep your mind in the middle, a leg on each side, and you might avoid the wreck. You've never felt you were a rock till you've ridden on a hurricane deck. Some folks never get it, some can't get enough. Some of us feed on the danger and crave the adrenaline rush. So we climb down in the buck and shoot, not just to win a check. It's the thrill of the ride when they crack that gate, and I'm back on the hurricane deck. And time stands still when you're sitting in the middle of the back of a bucking horse. Storm blows up out of thin air, and it hits with a mighty force. Keep your mind in the middle, a leg on each side, and you might avoid the wreck. Ain't never felt you were a rock till you've ridden on a hurricane deck. Side, and you might avoid the wreck. You never felt you were wrong till you've ridden on a hurricane deck. You've never felt you were wrong till you've ridden on a hurricane deck.
And forget all about pulling and searching all over the place to locate tractor parts. Check out the most convenient place to find parts for any make, bztractorparts.com. Massey Ferguson, Ford, John Deere, David Brown, Case, International Harvester, Universal, Deutz, Lightland, Landini, Oliver Flat, Ali, Zegor White, and so many more. Just call 250-395-0960. Email bztractorparts56@gmail.com.
Plant your fields. Kathie Moss is visiting us from Oregon this week. And Kathie, what about your background with horses?
I started my first colt when I was 10. And I had a three-year-old mules when I started out with, which taught me a lot about patience. And when I sold him for $200 and I bought me a filly. And from that filly, Dad started bringing in other horses. He was a horse trader, and at that time I thought a horse trader was a honest living. Come to find out, there's a few little plugs in there that ain't quite as complimentary as what I thought. But Pop would bring those horses home to me, and I would work with them for a couple of weeks, and the next thing I'd know, by the time I got home from school, those horses would be gone, and three or four more horses would be standing in their place. So I would dink with them until I got them where I wanted them, and then I'd come home from school, and they'd be gone, and more would be in their place.
Do you ever have any pretty challenging, scary ones to work with?
I've had a few that have just totally stumped me. And one was Brown Jug. It was one of Pop's pretty brown horse. God, he was pretty. But, you know, pretty is pretty does. And as they say, you can't ride their head. But in some instances, I think that I overdone that rule because I've been between their ears several times.
Brown Jug ever put you on the ground?
You know, Dad wouldn't let me ever get on him. He was one of those fellers that you'd, one day you could lead him out of the barn and he'd be fine, and the next day he'd run right over the top of you. One day you could saddle him good, and the next day he'd just take you. And so we finally took him and stuck him in the bucking string with Gibbs was our neighbor, and he had a bucking string. And he was a bucker there for about a year and a half, and then he just quit bucking too, so they sold him, and I don't know for sure what the story is after that, but I do know that when I saw him come out of the buck and shoot there in Haynes Stampede, there in Haynes, Oregon, that little horse had some breaks, and I'm glad Pop never let me get on him.
Yeah, a little easier to watch him down there in the arena.
Yeah, I can admire from a distance.
Well, Kathie, I'm sure glad you made it to Kamloops, and really enjoyed hearing what you've done, and I know our listeners are going to enjoy hearing it too. And be sure and say hello to Leon and Billy if you run into them for us.
Absolutely. I'll sure do that, Hugh. And thanks a million. This has been an absolute... Canada has been just so great to me, and the response here is absolutely outstanding. And I sure appreciate the response that they've given.
Kathie has a real nice website. It's akmossbooks.com. And boy, there's some incredibly beautiful videos on that site as well. Coming up, you'll hear a great example of her cowboy poetry and more of that pure Western music when the Spirit of the West continues right after this.
Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Coming up is another great song about cowboy life. And Kathie Moss, who's been my guest for the whole program here, writes poetry from real-life experience. And this one I'm sure is going to ring true for a lot of farriers. She calls it Reset.
I noticed the other day as I was feeding some hay, his toes were a little too long, for he stumbled and fell. Near as I could tell, I had waited a little too long for you to come and shoe. I've shod him a time or two. I used to shoe horses, you know. Reset what he has on. He hasn't had him that long. Heck, I put him on a year or so ago. Well, sure, it looks like he's on skis, but that's just so I can ease him to a slide and stop like a pro. Working cattle in a pen on a muddy day is when we slid a world record, you know. I was high in my seat. His butt was clear on the ground. He was walking out that slide, and I was sitting there with pride until I saw where we were bound. We could have slid more if it wasn't for hitting that fence head on. But I kept my seat as he tried to find his feet and figured out what had went wrong. And a month or so ago, in the slush and the snow, I roped a pretty sick cow. But that cow horse and me were like on a ski as she pulled us around somehow. My horse had on his brake, the ski marks we'd make, and I was sitting high in the breeze. She may have looked pretty sick, but next time I will pick one that can't pull us through the trees. Wish you could see this cow horse and me. We make a good team, you know. But if you'd be so kind and reset this friend of mine, he just needs a little off the toe.
Well, I have another great one from Kathie coming up, and I'm sure Matt Johnson can relate to that one. Right now, here's Kim Blakely. And you might wonder what a cowboy dreams about when nighttime comes, and maybe this'll help you find out.
He ain't nothing but a cowboy, just in boots and Wrangler jeans. He's a rider and a roper, sometimes gentle and sometimes mean. Some nights he dreams of range fires, young wild horses and stampedes. But each night before the sunrise, he dreams of what he really needs. He don't always dream of roundups or ghost riders in the sky. Most nights he dreams of moonlight shining in some cowgirl's eyes. It ain't just spurs and saddles that cross a cowboy's mind. It's usually love and rainbows what a cowboy dreams at night. Been a loner, that's the life he chose to live. But he's never been a taker, because he has his heart to give. Well, the movies made him an outlaw, lonesome, ornery, and lame. It's plain to see those makers never walked through a cowboy's dream. 'Cause he don't always dream of roundups or ghost riders in the sky. Most nights he dreams of moonlight shining in some cowgirl's eyes. It ain't just spurs and saddles that cross the cowboy's mind. It's usually love and rainbows what a cowboy dreams at night. It's usually love and rainbows what a cowboy dreams at night.
Kim Blakey, good song.
The way the Canada Revenue Agency deals with ranchers and farmers has changed a lot in the last few years, and the financial decisions we make today can have a long-lasting impact on our bottom line far into the future. It really helps to have a trusted professional who really understands your situation to guide you with all your accounting requirements and your tax preparation. Having an accountant who knows the difference between a Hereford and a heifer, what a slick and backgrounding are, and that Alfalfa and Timothy are not just names from a storybook really helps. Kathie McMillan of PMT Chartered Professional Accountants understands the intricacies of specialized programs like AgriStability and AgriInvest. She understands the demands on your time and can help you spend more time doing your job and less time dealing with endless piles of paperwork. See PMTaccountants.com or call toll-free 877-383-8081.
We're going to wrap this up this week with another one of Kathie Moss's poems, and I think if you listen closely, you'll get the message. It's called, "You'll Never Ride Again."
They said he'd never ride again across the sagebrush land. They said he'd never ride again. A rope no longer fit his hand. The day they made that decision was a day they thought he'd cry. For the day they made that decision was a day they thought he'd die. It was morning at online camp. He remembers like yesterday, just him, 10 horses, and 4,000 head to fill his summer days out in the YP ranch in Nevada. A job like those before. Just him and miles of rolling hills. A typical riding chore. He was heading some cows in the sagebrush. He was pushing hard to take the lead when his horse fell in a badger hole, traveling at breakneck speed. He don't remember the tumbling action. Actually, he don't remember the fall. But when he awoke an hour later, he was alone. That's all he could recall. He lay there in the sagebrush. He knew he wasn't right, for his body was misshapen. And no matter how hard he would fight to move a finger or a toe or bring his arm back to his side, his brain would give the commands to them, but his body would not abide. He knew no one would be traveling that way. It could be days or weeks before another soul would come along, a person in which he could speak. He lay there for 3 hours or more, an entire lifetime in one day, a man alone out in the desert. In a helpless kind of way. When a tingle crawled through his limbs and screamed into his spine, ricocheting off his shoulders and neck, no mercy for his mind. With his feelings back and pain on high, he moved around a bit, trying to get his equilibrium and strength enough to sit. This man crawled, and he hobbled to his truck, over 3 miles away. A miracle for those who heard his radio call that day. For his neck was broke in 3 places, his vertebra smashed through, his ligaments, nerves, and muscles were ripped from the bone. His shoulder was broke, too. They said he'd never ride again across the sagebrush land. They said he'd never ride again. A rope no longer fit his hand. The day they made that decision was a day his family would cry. For the day they made that decision was a day they thought he'd die. Yet, I rode with him the other day. His spurs, they jingle loud. And that rawhide rietta he made himself, he holds in his hand so proud. He swung a large loop. He caught a calf. He pulled a slack true. His eyes, they twinkle under that hat, a soft yet pure blue. With the help of family and friends, he's on his feet once more to be what he was born to be. for the brush again scratches his taps, for he's a cowboy through and through, heart, mind, and soul. And to quit or give up are words this breed just doesn't know. And I feel a bit of pride knowing him as a man, a cowboy, a friend. And it's an honor to ride with him until the last of the cows are brought in. You know, they said he'd never ride again across the sagebrush land. They said he'd never ride again, a rope no longer fit his hand. The day they made that decision after that dramatic spill was the day he made a decision, and he whispered, "Yes, I will."
Thanks again for making the ride, and I sure hope you can join us right here next week at the same time. And as always, thanks to Mark and Kathy McMillan, our great support crew. Now, be sure to check the latest issue of Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine for all kinds of great reading and pictures, and you can subscribe online at CanadianCowboy.ca. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel for this show and many more from the past, with video and lots of videos of the Western Spirit Band and ranching scenes and much more. The links are on our website, Hugh-McLennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.